The subject of this content is a detailed hands-on training on how to obtain Crealesson software and how to install and use it.
First of all, we will talk about the software in a very short and accelerated summary. Then the acquisition and installation of the software will be explained.
After making the necessary adjustments according to our preferences, we will talk about the keystroke features, namely the display of the mouse and keyboard keys on the screen. In another great tutorial we have prepared, we will try to cover all its other features extensively. And finally, we will present to you the information and research we have obtained that the software is clean and reliable. Crealesson is a next-generation integrated presentation and digital blackboard application. It is a great utility equipped with unlimited color options enriched with focusing tools, various pen, shape and drawing tools while preparing lecture presentations and digital educational content. You can customize your mouse pointer, as well as select the mouse keys and features that allow the keys entered from the keyboard to be displayed on the screen.
In addition, the program has shortcuts for almost all operations, so you will not be distracted by yourself or your students while lecturing.
You can easily make your educational content and presentation richer, more engaging, and easy to understand for audiences.
For the freemium or paid version of the Crealesson software, you must first download the Crealesson software from Google.
We write Softpedia. We can reach the Softpedia website in the search engine by clicking the link.
The structure and features of the Crealesson software are briefly mentioned. There is an easily visible download link on the site. There are two options, paid and free versions. For the paid full version, the option to purchase is available just above.
We will try to promote the program by choosing the free option. And I prefer to download the freemium version.
Click Softpedia Secure Download to create a download link, and the download will happen soon. Now I just click the link, zip format, about 65 megabytes. The download is almost complete.
We move the downloaded file to the desktop where we can see it easily. The installation file is in the compressed zip format file that we downloaded. There is software we use to extract it. You may be using WinRAR zipware or other software. Now we will export our setup file from the zip file.
The setup file has arrived. Now let's leave our zip file aside.
Our installation file is ready to perform the installation. Yes, I'm removing our zip file as we no longer need it.
Setup file. The setup menu opens immediately. We continue with the next option. We continue to move forward by saying the next step. In the next step, it also shows the directory where the program will be installed. This directory contains the address where we will install the software.
We have finished the installation. Now the program is ready to use.
The Crealesson software is the first screen where we see the user interface and language. We have set our user language to English. To switch to the interface and language setting again, it will be enough to click on the settings here. We will then be able to change our language options and preferences. We will continue with the English language. After the language selection is made, the hotkey section at the top of the settings opens automatically. From there, we can leave or change the necessary settings as usual. We will change some settings, and we will see the hotkeys. They are the shortcuts of the program tools that will make our work easier during the use of the program.
There is a small window called Career Mentor. It is a useful section that shows some important details of the program and visually explains some of its features during use.
If we don't want to see it initially, just tick the box. We will close this window for now.
It will reappear in Career Mentor at the next program launch. We will also show some features through Career Mentor.
Hotkey section. Another part is the presentation part. Here we have some important settings. And the most important part is actually on-screen display. Here we will specify the keystroke settings. When the program is open, we can see mouse movements when I click on the desktop or anywhere. When the right or left button is clicked, we can see which button is clicked next to the cursor. Here the details of mouse settings continue. and we will consider more detailed settings related to the keyboard. In other words, they are the settings related to the display of keyboard keys. Keycap labels is the settings section that allows the names of the keys on the keyboard to be displayed as labels in a small frame on the screen. After making a few important settings on the hotkeys, we will move on to the on-screen display settings. We have summarized what we will do in the first step. Now, when I open and close the program, when I go to the first shutdown option, there is a hide button about the program running in the background. We see the taskbar option or the process of closing the program completely, or we can choose the cancel option. The program runs in the background in the taskbar section. When I close it, we close the program completely and we can no longer use keystroke and all other features of the program. I open the program again, and every time I open it, the Crealesson message appears again. We want it to reappear on every boot to make it permanent. Let's talk about the first settings we will make on hotkeys.
Since we prefer OBS Studio as screen recording software, we do not want to take advantage of screen recording features here. Of course, you can use it if you wish.
Here, we set it to Control plus F9 as we chose F9 to start and stop recording in OBS Studio. Likewise, we change the record from F10 to Control plus F10.
My OD setting is a shortcut to toggle mouse strokes and keystroke settings on or off. I set this as the escape key. Now we continue from the keystroke settings while the program is running in the background without opening a presentation. We can use the keystroke, that is, show the keyboard and mouse keys on the screen.
Let's do a few basic operations to adjust the presentation settings later. One of the first and most important settings for us is the hide or reveal setting for the mouse and keyboard keys to be displayed on the screen. We will prefer to see mouse and keyboard strokes during the presentation. We preferred automatic numbering for arrows. One of the ready-made shape tools. We will talk about the details of this tool during the presentation. Soft drawing is an option that will keep its form and help us draw better. We leave our other settings as usual. In this setting, we determine the board background style preferences that are open during the presentation. Retro style and abandoned school board or green board or chalkboard with pattern instead of solid colors. You can see many other different styles. You can change it depending on your preferences.
It could even be a whiteboard. Presentation mode is turned on. Chalk will appear on the screen as the default tool. We can change the startup tool, but we will leave it as chalk. Of course, he could also start with a pen or other tools.
We prefer that the chalk tool appears selected each time the program opens, and we want the chalk vehicle color to stay white.
Presentation settings were important in this sense, and we completed it at the basic level. OSD, the most important setting is the on-screen display setting. The most basic and most important settings regarding the display of mouse strokes and keyboard keys, namely keystroke. We wanted to disable a feature related to fast recording. There is a shortcut to start or stop recording with a double click while the program is running.
Crealesson software has recording feature, but we don't want that because we already use OBS Studio for this reason. We do not want the Crealesson software to start recording automatically when we click anywhere to times. Finally, we come to our main and most important setting, keystroke. That is, how to show the keyboard and mouse keys on the screen is determined on screen display. Under this header, there will also be mouse and keyboard settings. Here are the display properties and color preferences of the PI selected mouse keys, mouse stroke display settings that we choose according to the preferences we want. We will preferably use the default style and size to X, of course. We will make a setting for this here as well. We will prefer the small setting. The transparent property shows the transparency of mouse clicky properties. Vertical margin is the setting of the mouse's proximity and distance from the cursor. We set it as the closest option to the mouse cursor. There is a feature that makes a click sound for every keystroke we enter from the keyboard or when we click the mouse.
We will not use the click sound feature. We will disable it for that. If I choose the smallest of the default setting, the image shrinks to this approximately. And we do not prefer this because the keystroke, which is very important to us, is also very small.
Standard default is not large enough. We will prefer a setting that is 2 times the default setting.
And here we enter the detail settings of the mouse. This is the part where we define the color of the mouse cursor. Our choice is green. Setting to show or not show mouse click state feature is available here. If we turn off the show setting, it won't show which key was pressed on the mouse. If we turn off the show mouse stroke setting, it won't show which key was pressed on the mouse. We want it to be actively displayed. Thus, our mouse settings are complete.
We came to the keyboard settings. We will determine the appearance of the keyboard keystroke keys on the screen. Font, we can choose Arial Bold or a different font.
Let's change it now. Many different fonts are available here. We want to make it look its best to the user. Preferably, this style seems more appropriate to us. Depending on the font feature, thick or thin can be preferred.
There is a timing setting for how long keystrokes and mouse strokes stay on the screen when presentation mode is active.
Fair font size is a feature that allows the label to fit into the frame as much as possible when we press a key on the keyboard. We will leave this selected so that viewers can easily keep track of which keyboard key you press.
In the Show Resolved Characters section,
you can show it in detail with lowercase and uppercase letters in parentheses. We wanted it to show the letters we entered as a preference in one and large size. That is enough for us.
The underline feature also shows the effect of which key you press on each keystroke, or it stays underlined when you hold it down. This is a feature that is shown when you press or hold a key. We will use this too. It will remain selected for us.
Just below there is a setting where we show keystroke colors. It needs to be marked as custom font color for it to appear. After marking, the keystroke will now be visible in the color you selected.
The keystroke is keycap labels. Tags are encoded as alt-opt by default in our settings. But we just edited them to alt. I changed the control key to CTRL for the shortcut. The F9 key is important for us. Let's make it clear so that we can see it on the screen when the F9 key is pressed.
For the appearance of the right control key, we set it to RCTRL by placing a large R in front of it. I am checking here to see if there's anything I need for other settings. These are good keycap labels, settings for my preference. On-screen display, that is, the display of mouse strokes and features, and our most basic and most important settings regarding keyboard keys. Keystroke are now complete.
One remaining feature is the setting for mouse strokes to follow the cursor, either display of mouse strokes or the position of keyboard keystroke views. A setting that allows the mouse cursor to be displayed at the edge of the mouse pointer or at a distant point.
We want the keystroke views to be right next to the mouse cursor, following the mouse cursor instead of being far away, because it will show the viewer much better which keyboard key is pressed or which mouse key is pressed. Even when we open and close the program completely, our settings remain permanently. Our settings are permanent until we change them. We minimize the program to the system taskbar. The program is currently running in the background, and I could see mouse hits on the screen. Let's test the settings we made by creating a notepad here. Now let's show the keystroke. That is, the keys entered from the keyboard on the screen. The text file has been created. Let's come to the name right away. I said test version 1. After saying enter, we finished. I just moved it to the top corner. I will write something soon. I select, copy and paste the text I typed, and here you can easily watch how keystroke looks from the keyboard above. Thus, we have made a visual and practical explanation of how we use the keystroke features. Right after we show the key usage live, we can now close our program again. Keystroke, in order to show the keystrokes better and more detailed on the keyboard.
we entered less commands than the mouse. You will already be able to see mouse keys and strokes more often.
Mouse click features are already in progress. Thus, we have completed the practical and applied explanation in detail about the display of keystrokes on the screen.
In the following sections, we will try to explain the output settings of the program and general settings related to the presentation, the tools we will use during the presentation, and other important detail features of the Crealesson software.
From where we left off, we will show the remaining detail settings of the interface and go directly to the presentation section. We'll then move on to the details of the Blackboard section in the presentation, various tools, and more. That's it for now. We've completed this section. We will share with you the link of the content where we will introduce the other comprehensive features of the Crealesson software in a comprehensive way.
Let's come to the security of the site and the software. Now we can move on to our short information section about the Crealesson software virus total scan.
As we showed earlier, the site has an information section that states it is 100% clean and reliable. When we open the short information section about the security and software of the site, it talks about security details. Of course, we will scan and test the software and the site on the virus total web page. First, let's check the zip file we downloaded as a file. When we look, we do not see a problem.
When we examine the installation file in the same way over virus total, we see that it does not pose any problems. It looks pretty clean.
In addition, we reached the real address of the software .exe file and scanned it again with virus total. Again, according to the virus total scan results, we see that there is no threat.
And finally, as you know, there are free or pay versions of Crealesson software. If you wish, you can purchase the Crealesson software as a full version with all its features.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.